Thank you. Alright, this might be interesting.
What's that?
So I can get this thing out of here.
Oh. There's it doesn't have collision all the way out to the end, so it makes it a little easier.
You're not kidding. Better.
Yep.
I again couldn't get GPS to work in there.
Oh, you couldn't?
It won't take off and run for me.
Huh. But it works in here?
Yep.
That's weird.
Like right now, if I were to get this thing flipped around so it does it right. I'll set you figure out. Off and running.
That's crazy. I wonder why it is that way. Misses a couple here and there though, but that could be just my drive.
They won't stop.
Make that just know just a little bit more yet.
Why?
Because you missed quite a bit too on the way back.
No, that was because the GPS shut up.
Oh, okay.
It's fine.
All right.
I
At least it's not leaving gaps anymore. Like it was.
Right.
That was leaving a pretty wide gap, look at that. Not no more. I was gonna go north and south on this part.
Oh, okay.
Just so I could test to make sure it works going both directions.
I understand.
And it looks like it's fine. That's good. That's been fixed. Notice the bin fills differently in multiplayer now too.
Yeah. Yeah, actually.
It actually fills like it does in like single player now. So they must have something else in that update must have fixed some other things. Man, they're going crazy.
Sarah's home.
Oh, I see. That would be why.
Alright, sorry.
No, no worries. That give us one more room, a little bit more room down from the end.
Alright, I figured out in the field mode, I figured out how to make it skip around.
Yep.
How do you make it turn?
Make a turn? Alright. So, when you have it up, there is a GPS end field mode.
Mm-hmm.
Lower right. Click that, and it's gonna initiate the end of field. So it means when it gets to the end of the field, it'll stop. It won't do anything. Hit it once more, and you have an arrow with a left-hand turn.
Oh, there it is.
Then what you need to do is set up your stop distance. Right now it's set up, the default's at 1.0. Now, because we're halfway through the field, it probably isn't going to work that great. Because it goes from the edge of the field.
Right.
So if you set it up now, it's going to go all the way, you're going to run all the way down to the end and turn around and come all the way back. To correct that, you just don't cut a field in half like we did.
I get that, but, okay.
So then, the header width is usually, well, these headers I think are 15. I think they're 15 meters wide. So if you set up your stop distance to 10, it'll go 5 meters past the end and then begin to turn. And that's usually enough that you have enough room there to turn. Sometimes you gotta play with it to adjust to make it, you know, where the sweet spot is for when it turns. And then you can start skipping lanes and all that fun stuff too once you get it to automatic turn. And then once it's set up, all you have to do is basically just run it and it will do automatic turns and you'll walk away for a while and come back later and hope you're not in a ditch.
Alright, so free lanes, 9.8 is the stop, is the end. I have it skipping, turning right. See what happens. Nope, oh, you're in that one, so I would skip two.
Oh, yeah, it should have went over.
You're fine.
I'm not even sure I'm gonna grab that on the way back. It's gonna be close. I just kinda guesstimated where you were at and how many rows I was taking. You want to make sure that the arrow is going the right way at the end too. So if it's turning right, you're going to go right. Left goes left.
Ooh, that's not quite enough. So that 9.8 needs to be higher then, right?
Yes. The higher the number, the farther away from the field it will stop.
The farther away from the end.
Yep.
Right?
Yep, farther away from the end, and it will stop and initiate the turn. Usually what I took two rows off there, so technically you could have set that to like 20, and then you wouldn't have went too far and would have turned and would have been good. So yeah, GPS works. They don't miss anything with GPS, so that's a good boost. They're pretty much set up right where I have the nodes for the headers where the GPS line's set up, so that's interesting. Getting all that. I thought it was more the AI or a number given to it for width. And anything as far as traps are, gross, that's good.
Great. Okay, Sarah just walked in, hold on.
Yep. Rows it takes at a time. It's not bad.
That's all?
Yep. Well, let's see, 18 rows on. Let's do the math, see if that scaled correctly. So 18 rows on 30 inch spacing is 45 feet. So that would be correct. The hash are true to the game spacing drop.
Nice. That's pretty cool. So it all worked out the way it's supposed to.
Yep. So the 45 foot head takes 18 rows of soybeans on 30 inch rows. Cool.
Yeah.
That's my favorite truck. Which is where... Probably parked. There it is. Oh. Gotta go get maintenance first. Took two starts. Checking off the header.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the left side or right side, if you're in the combine, is missing about a foot and a half of the knife section. But ain't much I can do about it. It would take blender work to create a small section and import it in. Seems awfully high. That's better. This Kinsey turret needs to unload fast.
Yes, it does. Of course, right now it's being filled again, so...
True.
That's why it's not unloading very quickly. Whatever you just took out, I put back in.
Truck. all the truck in is just pretty much falling. So on this map, there's a couple of these side roads here that are like glitchy. And like textures that kind of like bounce back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
I fixed that now.
Okay.
There's what it is that there's two roads laying on top of each other, and they're fighting for which one shows.
So oh, so you just gotta move them.
Yeah, you just gotta resize the road. So that way they're not overlapping on each other and fighting each other for who gets to be viewed and who don't.
Oh, well, that's easy.
Yep. Just gotta find them all. That's the hardest part of it. Did you take the end off on that other end? The other end of the field?
No, I should have, but I didn't.
Okay.
GPS was doing its thing, and I wasn't paying attention, and it turned, and... a dog in here. The quiet one. You nearly care which one's quiet, they're both making noise all night. Yeah. You can't make it turn right, you can only make it turn left?
No, it will turn left. It should alternate back and forth.
Nope.
See the two arrows next to each other? Hit one of those and it makes it go the other way. It forces it to turn the other direction if you don't want it to turn.
Oh, there it goes.
So if you're coming down and you don't want to turn right, you just hit zero to the left and switches it so it switches, so it forces it to turn the way you want it to turn.
Right. was gonna say, what are you getting out for?
Yeah, I'm pretty shocked that came out right. 18 rows on 30 inch spaces. 45 feet.
Finally did it. You got us good combines.
Yep.
We've only been talking about it for a while.
Yep. Got the JD HUD on the inside. I mean, there's other stuff I could do. IC controls. It's got the mirrors, which is pretty cool. Well,
you can always release these, let them go, and then after you get bored, you can come back in, add the IC controls to these, and then that'll make them there, ours, and then there's theirs and ours. Just like you'll be
different. Hopefully it's a cloud spot there that wasn't planted. A little rough going there. But this HUD thing is pretty cool. After it took me an hour placing that dang decimal point in here. Nope, that wasn't quite right. I finally got the right spot. Then I was like, well, that'd be cool to have a semicolon down where it has the time in. So when I start farting all of that, now I have a semicolon between the digits at the bottom. The only thing that's kind of goofy is there's no decimal point for your hours or the hectares combined it, but I'm not too concerned about it. I just bugged me when I said I'm going 60 miles an hour. Only going 6. So, decimal place had to be put in. That was just bugging me. Then I took out the two cameras too, because I just didn't see the need for the two cameras on the header. We're gonna whack off two ends of this, yeah. That's the best way to do it.
I'm just freestyling and...
Yeah, so I'm just following where you've gone, overlapping one row, just gives me something. Yeah, I'm pretty proud of this achievement of getting up to work.
This is nice. These are really nice. It matches everything else you've done.
Yep. You know, it's a good combine to start with. I just put the right kind of tracks on it and did a whole bunch of other stuff.
The bigger thing for me was the head.
Yes, we have two John Deere heads now.
Yes, the real head instead of that weird...
Yeah, that reskin case head. And it has severe, awesome header flow. Look at that. That's just beauty. Gonna follow the GPS line, or are you resetting it?
I just reset it.
Alright.
Got it?
Yep, got it.
You're taking an extra one.
Yep.
I thought I saw it doing that on mine.
It's gonna do that. Because really, it's actually taking it, but if you look, your header's actually picking that roll off.
Yes, it is.
It's just, this is moving the top layer of the actual crop. But maybe even if you look at the map yourself, you see this little strip there. Had you just moved over and just took what you could see, you'd leave a little strip. And that's right. That's something within the, how a game recognizes where the header is and where it's going to take the comment. The way around that is you line up on your outside row, 9 rows in, you put the green line to your GPS dead center between the 2 rows, and it won't do that no more. Because right now it's on the one side of the 10th row.
Right. I see that.
Not to be all technical.
I understand technical, you're fine. I'm picking up what you're putting down.
The lights look a lot better too than when I'm what used to be.
Oh, it's gonna be close. I don't think I'm gonna make it.
Oh yeah, your bin's getting pretty full there. It's pretty close. Yeah, we had about what, 300 feet to go.
I just want to drive my tractor in. I need to get these over here and get them in there.
Yeah. Set yourself a new path. And when I come by, you should be able to set it and it's gonna move you open a little bit.
Got it. 15.3. Is that right?
No, it should be 13.8.
That's grab 15.3.
Should be right around, 15, maybe 30 feet? No. I don't know how that meter thing works.
Yeah, it's not about it.
Not even good. Alright. Yeah, 13.8 is about right. Red lines in the center of the outside, though. Figuring out the track wobble, with the, you know how the tracks pivot with the ground textures.
Mm-hmm.
That was kind of handy. When I first had it all set up and loaded, it was almost standing on its end. So there's 2 sets of wheels that determine how it travels on the ground, and it correlates to itself or lines itself to those 3 wheels. So I had to bring the one back down, bring the other one up a little bit, so that way it would rotate it and lay it flat. And then after that, it was good to go. But it took me like a day and a half to figure that out. But now I know from the future. Coming back on that? Yeah, you're coming back on that.
Yep.
I'm gonna split this. Of course, I will not make it all over the edge. That's bad idea in my home. Yeah, 13.8 ain't quite right. Okay, do an adjustment. Probably 13.5. Why, when you have a full thing, you don't split the field. You're a cart driver.
Yes, we do.
Where's Bros at?
Having a baby.
Just made that turn, didn't you?
10.4 is not quite right either.
No, might want to go, I would go probably close to 16, 18, because you have two rows here that we took off, or two widths. So you can set it up probably at 18, and then it'll auto-turn in the field. Oh, come on, I didn't miss the trigger that bad, did I? Yeah.
Are you coming right back down, or are you skipping?
I counted over, I think, 4.
Okay.
I have the cart file on me.
You what?
I have the cart file on me, you can call him.
Oh, jeez. Well, he should pick up that first row. Did it right.
I caught a couple. 2 extra on this one. I didn't reset it back square.
Did it right. Cool.
I skipped the one and came over and got that one.
Skip two. Yep.
Yeah, it's pretty neat when you get it all figured out, how it all the turn and all that. I'll be really sick if I get this track to drive up alongside you while it's attached to me still, so you can unload. Close enough to you, or they gotta move them over a little bit?
Gotta come over a little bit. A little more. One empty. Why is it not empty?
Is he not over far enough?
Not be over far enough.
Alright, I'll put him over one more. There you go.
There it goes.
That's skills.
Now that is some GPS and follow me skills right there.
That's some skills right there.
You got GPS and follow me going.
Empty?
I'm not, but it's full, I think.
Oh, it might be full. Okay. We'll just hold it there. You don't need no heart runner.
No. Okay, let's see if I did this right. It should go right down this one. Got it.
Yep, got it. I'll offload what I got here and then we'll grab the truck.
We don't need no cart runner.
That only works on big fields.
Yeah. That's not gonna work so swell on you. Something's wrong.
Oh, it's so fast and slow. We will have to fix that. Even though it is probably technically pretty close to realistic. Yeah. Unload that thing in like open flat. Alright, let's do this without knocking a bunch of stuff. Stop and let you turn the corner. Wow, you can really set this way behind you. How full are you?
Almost 19. I'm putting what I can on the truck since I'm right here.
Yeah. Good plan.
Build the truck, so it'll take that.
Taking it in? Must be, I just heard it.
Yeah. Filled it, so I might as well.
I
I'm leaving like 100 rows.
It's fun, it's like driving a Royal Patrol car. Right here is John Deere's new machine sink.
Machine what?
Machine sink.
Machine sink?
They actually have that. I don't know what the actual name is called, but they actually have it where like the tractor is synced with the combine. You don't even have to drive it, it just knows by either GPS system or something like that, that it drives right next to the combine. You don't have to actually drive it.
Wow. I've
seen a video on it like years ago.
So they really do have Follow Me then?
Yes, they really have Follow Me. this thing in the ditch now. Oh, and it's going to make me back this up. That would have went right in there. Oh, bloop. And it's still gonna go in there. Shoot. Oh, that bites.
Uh-oh.
Just put a hold on that. Oh, cool. Deal with that when I get back down there. I must have done an extra loop-de-loop back there.
I saved it.
Okay.
I didn't want to hang in there. I felt like I was going to fall.
Thank you.
I feel like playing rescue soon tonight.
Yeah. Leaving one.
Yeah, it looks like it's leaving one.
Yeah.
This is awesome. I can farm and brush the dogs all at the same time.
One and then that little horseshoe.
How do you... Can you get something to follow you if you just back up to it?
No, you have to be in the vehicle and assign it to the trail. one half follow. But you can dismiss him from behind with the vehicle in front of you.
Right.
Either frontward or back, you can dismiss him. But for adhering them to you, you gotta be in the view if you wish to adhere to the trail.
Okay.
This long field, we should be able to do that remote control thing again. Oh, it was following you already. Not bad.
Yeah. Alright.
Hoping I get the corn by about Thursday. I could test the corn headers and then Friday I'll schedule the post and let it go. So I think the green head's good to go. The little head's already good to go because that was already in game from a different combine mod. So the little one shouldn't have any problems with it.
Yeah, we really haven't used that one.
No. We will have to use both corn heads though. Just so we can test both out, make sure they're good to go. this field partially opened up. I'll call it a night.
Works for me.
Okie dokie. That's enough for tonight.
Okie dokie. I don't know what the heck is going on. I got something weird happening.
Oh, yeah?